As you see on our campus today, our flags are flying half-mast. This is a sad time for our Youngstown State University family, and it is also a sad time for our Mahoning Valley community. Today, we made grief counseling available to our students and others, and we had several individuals take advantage of this service. We also had a prayer service earlier today. We're doing our very best as a community to get together, to grieve, and ultimately, folks, to heal.
We were brought together, or have been brought together on this occasion, by a tragedy of unspeakable proportion that occurred in this community. And our prayers and our thoughts and our condolences go out to the family of the victim, Mr. Johnson, who was deceased, and to those who were injured. But out of this tragedy can come an opportunity. And that opportunity has to do with our governor. Less than 24 hours ago, I, as mayor of the city of Youngstown, along with Dr. Anderson and Police Chief Jimmy Hughes, all received personal calls on our cell phone from Governor John Kasich. He asked for us to explain to him how he, as the governor in this state, could be of assistance. Less than 24 hours ago, we sent to him a list of things that we thought would be of significant benefit. And in less than 24 hours, he made his way here to Youngstown, Ohio, to this campus, with a response to every one of the things that we put on that list. And these were very pragmatic requests. And he came and brought many of his members of his cabinet. He had done the research, he and his staff had done the research, and were able to provide us answers to every one of those things. I can tell you that I've been mayor for 5.5 years now. I've been around in politics and involved in public service, and I have never been more impressed with not the governor because he's politically savvy, but because the governor called, asked us to provide him a list of needs, and then in less than 24 hours came with answers and responses to every one of those, with commitments for this state to help not only the city of Youngstown and Youngstown State University, but the Mahoning Valley, and things and taking actions that will be of benefit to this entire state of Ohio. So to the governor, again, I want to personally thank you for the phone call, for the request, and for responding. Again, not coming with platitudes and to make us feel better, but coming with real answers and real solutions to real problems that have existed here for a number of years. And again, I couldn't have been more impressed and couldn't be more appreciative for the commitment of the governor and his staff. And the partnership that this city and this university have experienced for the past decade has made us both stronger, has made us both better off. And I am committed to making sure that I work with Dr. Anderson and the trustees here, and I can't speak on behalf of Youngstown City Council, but I'm sure I'm expressing the sentiments that the Youngstown City Government and the administration and staff of here of Youngstown State University are determined not to allow this heinous crime to define us. That is not who we are. We are not going to be defined by the unfortunate events that have transpired in the past, or this most unfortunate event that has transpired in these past couple of days.
So whether it is the problem of alcohol and drug abuse, whether it is the problem with establishments that operate in violation of our liquor laws, whether it's an ability for this community to be able to claim its own land and be able to rehabilitate and reutilize this vacant land, or whether it is cooperation between the Highway Patrol, the Department of Public Safety, we can become partners. And I want to say this is a wonderful university. Back in Columbus, we talk about Ohio State as being part of the Ohio State community. Youngstown State, this is part of a community. This is part of a need for us to dig down deep. And as I suggested to the mayor and the president, it would be terrific to be able to engage our houses of worship, whether we can get our ministers and our rabbis to join together, to know where our children are. A poor 17-year-old girl at 3:40 in the morning finds violence. We all want to think about why that happens. But we're going to lift ourselves. Mahoning Valley's best days are ahead. There is no question about it.